The 1972 summit series between Canada and the Soviets showed how even the two nations were, with just one victory separating them.
Canada!
35 years later, it has been all Canada. Four games in Russia, four dominating Canadian wins.
He's absolutely crushed by Brandon Sheehan. From Sherbrooke, Quebec, what an individual effort. He scores!
Now we're back home.
On our ice, in front of our fans.
Game five starts now.
We came because we love Canada.
Here's another shot. Fight, fight, fight.
Yes, the scene has shifted to Canada. Is there any chance left the momentum will shift to Russia? We'll find out if these guys have any life left shortly. The Maple Leaf has appeared in many shapes and sizes on Canadian hockey sweaters over the years, but this one is unmistakable. The spirit of 72 will be worn by the juniors of 07 tonight in Winnipeg as Team Canada attempts to clinch the Super Series.
The 2007 Canada-Russia Super Series is brought to you by Nike. Medals last longer than pain. Join the summer shift at niketraining.ca. And by Chevrolet. Let's go. Visit letsgochevrolet.ca.
And our starting goaltender is also brought to you by Chevrolet. Let's go. Visit letsgochevrolet.ca. Sergei Bobrovsky. His third action tonight for the Russians. He's been the better of the two Russian goaltenders. Neither has been good. Jonathan Bernier pitched a shutout in Game 1 as Canada continues the rotation. Here are Peter and Pierre.
James, thank you very kindly. The officials, as in the referees, are from Russia. Slava Bulanov and Alexander Polikov have made the trip. The linesman from the Western Hockey League, Kendrick Nicholson and Matthew Traub. In the first game in Canada. Game 5 of the Super Series is nicely underway. Myrov runs into Colton Gillies as Brent Sutter wastes little time, Pierre, making a quick change.
Well, he wants to save the Sutter line for Anisimov's line.
The Russians are the home team. They do have last change. Corey Emerton of the Kingston Frontenacs racing in against Alexei Grishin. Logan Pyatt looking for Gillies just out of his reach. As the puck belongs again to Gillies of the Saskatoon Blades, and you know he's looking for it already for playing in front of his regular fans tomorrow in Saskatoon as Boychuk crunches Grishin with a huge hit, and Grishin is really shaken after he was clobbered by the Lethbridge Hurricane.
No surprise here. Grishin's one of the most physical players for the Russians, and Canada wants to send a message early on. Grishin with a setup doesn't see Zach Boychuk. Boychuk just comes in and gives him the kabong from behind. But that's what you expect, and you got to see a lot of this from Team Canada if they're going to be successful here in game number 5. Because of the fatigue factor, because of the fact there could be a little bit of an offensive letdown, Canada's got to get physical early on, and they have been.
And the Russian referees elect to penalize Boychuk. So Team Russia on the power play, 59 seconds in to this opening period. And their power play has been a disaster. It's 1-for-35 in the series. Kulikov in his first appearance, his shot stopped by Bernier.
And Peter, you know what? That was the appropriate call. That was a penalty. That was a hit from behind. Again, Brent Sutter doesn't mind that. There's another one by Stefan Legion. And that's what you're going to see. Whether it's 5-on-5, shorthanded, Canada's going to be real physical.
The Russians have misfired in their last 32 straight manpower advantages. Talupa slides it for Evgeny Didonov. Down low and Ryabov with Anisimov to the front of the net. That was a tough shot in the short side, but Bernier handles it. Claude Giroux, who's done yeoman work in all neighborhoods of the game. And now a penalty upcoming to the Russians. As Kyle Turris was upended.
Well, you gotta like that, Peter. Again, Canada wanting to be very aggressive, and they are, whether it's hitting in 5-on-4 situations, forcing the puck with aggressive up-ice pressure, it doesn't matter. There's a penalty taken by Tulopov. and he'll go to the bottom. And Stefan Legion, this is what we're talking about. The guys from the Canadian team are so comfortable playing on the small ice. Legion identifies Ryabov and just pummels him into the wall with a clean hit.
Tolupov was actually cut from the original 26-man roster because he was out of shape here, but he's been added with a number of the Russian injuries. Plays in Chicoutimi in the Quebec League. Tolupov is a New Jersey third rounder. So we play 4-on-4 early in the opening frame. Maxime Mamet, a hard drive, turned aside easily by Bernier.
Bernier will gobble those up all the time. And there he was right on top of the crease. Easy save for him.
Carl Alsner, he's been a tower of strength on the Canadian blue line with Drew Doughty. Alsner. Voinov back with Tavares bumping him. David Perron joining Tavares. A physical beginning as we would have expected.
Well, one team's hitting, one team's receiving. And it's not a whole lot of fun to be a receiver in this game.
Both teams making changes. Alexandrov nearly coughed it up, but slides it ahead for Kulikov. Boychuk out of the penalty box, and Canada now enjoying its first power play of Game 5. They're 6 for 26 in the series. Vizhnevsky, Kulikov by himself just off his stick. Now he had a chance with a partially open net, but fanned again. Giroux in full flight with Lucic and Gagne. Gagne is Canada's leading scorer in this series with 7 points.
Vizhnevsky wanted nothing to do with Lucic in that situation.
Gagne with Lucic to the front of the net. Here's Giroux trying to jam it by Bobrovsky, and Bobrovsky dives on the loose disc.
This was all about getting the puck in deep, retrieval because of the Lucic presence on the forecheck, and then all the skill level of Canada kicking in. Lucic getting strong as Vizhnevsky. You see the support by Canada, Giroux, Gagne. Smart moving the puck back to the point, walking the line, creating seams. Gagne, such a great passer down low to Giroux. Gets one chance, two chances, and then Bobrovsky shuts everything down. But there's an example of Canada. Hard on the forecheck, good skill level, and smart decisions.
Hickey holds it in up front now. Turris with Hamel. Hickey in front. What a great chance for Hamel, but he chips it out of play.
You just can't stop admiring the skill level of the Canadian players. It's pass, pass, shot, boom. And it's all about quickness. Pass, another pass coming up, and then a quick shot. It's just pass, 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 and then boom. That's just great offensive zone hockey by the Canadians, and a great job by Zach Hamel moving into dead space.
Hamel tugged down after he chipped it out of play. The Western Hockey League's leading scorer last season with 93 points. Grecian back out there after being stung in the collision with Boychuk earlier. Canada's power play has expired. Hamel in traffic, and then it deflects right through the crease. Colton Gillies for Hamel. Zach Hamel from Port Coquitlam, British Columbia. And out it comes for Corey Emerson. 3-1 shots on goal early in favor of the Russians. And Pierre, it's nice to have a shots on goal clock that you can see.
Have a truck you can communicate with and show people good replays.
Vizhnevsky, the smooth skating defender and Dallas first rounder. Tadana versus Luke Chen. Chen taps it ahead for Legion. He has 3 goals in this set. Gives chase with Lucic. Legion with Brandon Sutter.
Vizhnevsky better take some courage pills or just not play against Lucic. He wants nothing to do with him. 29 in white against 22 in red.
Anisimov and Bernier gobbles it up. A bit of a bump. No score here in Winnipeg.
More Canada-Russia hockey coming your way in November on Rogers Sportsnet. It's the CHL ADT Canada-Russia Challenge. 2 games each in the Q, the OHL, and the WHL.
Vyacheslav Voinov. He's eligible for the upcoming National Hockey League draft. A real feather in his hat, Pierre, when he played for his national junior team in Sweden when he was only 16. And there's some great Russian players like Ovechkin and Malkin that didn't even do that.
Yeah. Voinov's going to be a real good player because he's not intimidating. He's got a lethal shot from the point on the power play.
Ryabev comes back out with Anisimov and Dodonov. The Russians need a lot more from Dodonov and Anisimov. Ryabev's been the best of that trio for sure. He has 2 goals to lead the Russians in that category in this series. Lucic of the Vancouver Giants. He'll be their captain this season. Bumps with Vishnevsky. Lucic back with Sutter and Legion. Godfrey shot deflects to the side of the net. 6-6 are the shots on goal. Brandon Sutter with Legion. The Columbus pick. Lucic just off the stick of Sutter.
Again, it's off the shooter. It's a great forecheck by Lucic. Good retrieval. And then the cycle game of Canada kicks in.
Fans, don't forget.
Cross check to Canada. Brandon Sutter.
Vyacheslav Bulanov, the veteran official of many international events, and Brent Sutter's team about to be shorthanded for the 3rd time in the opening period.
I think there was a little frustration there by Brandon Sutter and Team Canada. It was good domination by Canada, and then Brandon Sutter just about to go for a line change. Whacks his man right in the arm, Evgeny Dodonov.
Dodonov, a 3rd round pick of Florida.
Team Canada penalty.
In deep on the forecheck for the Canadiens, Claude Giroux. Turris joining him, along with Ellerby and Luke Shen, 2 Western Hockey League blue liners. Soladukin, Duronen. Duronen fans, and it'll allow the Canadiens to clear. Giroux takes a hard hit from Duronen, who plays in the Russian Super League with Ufa.
Peter, it's amazing how Canada just gets in the face of the Russians when they're killing penalties, and Canada takes away those lanes, and the Russians are frustrated. They don't know what to do with the puck.
Basunov. Nobody home where he put the puck, and Shen delivers it deep. Kurbatov bearing down on him is Emerton. Voinov, the outlet. Mammon with Basunov. Maxime Mammon scoops it in. Alsner trying to drive it out. Hit Mammon with it. Kurbatov blocked. That hurt Corey Emerton.
Emerton's played a real solid first period. Unheralded, but very solid.
Kurbatov, a shot kicked into the corner by Bernier. Mammon, he's thrown his weight around a couple of times in this period. Voinov holds it in to Vasuna. Bashkirov. Solid jolt on Alsner. Emerton. Vasunov intercepts. Just 13 seconds to go on the power play. Kurbatov fans. Another chance. Voinov rebound. Steered away by Payet. Gillies can't clear the zone. Brandon Sutter's out of the penalty box. And is content to send it behind the net.
That's the first time all series. Canada had 4 different times to clear the zone in a penalty kill situation. They didn't do it.
Canada 0 for 4 on the power play. The Russians now 0 for 3. Turned over. Marchand trying to go top shelf. Fired it too high. Looking for his series leading 4th. Klukov with Kulikov, and Hickey nearly directed it into his own net. He's picking up. Giroux, what a move. Claude Giroux with Marchand. Fantastic stop by Bobrovsky. Godfrey, the big blast. That had to hurt. Gagne, Bobrovsky. That was terrific, too. All kinds of pressure. Hickey a drive. That's blocked. Giroux. How about Sergei Bobrovsky?
Canada's got all kinds of weaponry, whether it be Josh Godfrey, who has a shot like Al MacInnis. Gives you a little example. Maxim Chudinov goes down, and that leaves a big mark. Sam Gagner trying to score on Bobrovsky, can't do it. Play stays alive. Good movement. Giroux back to the point. Big shot on goal. Lots of blocks. Giroux tees it up again. And then the high stick by Josh Godfrey. But total domination by Team Canada. And it all started by a great defensive play by Sam Gagner, forcing a turnover and then moving the puck to Brad Marchand.
Sergei Bobrovsky has faced nine shots. I would say he's made six great saves. What a collision involving Lucic and Vishnevsky.
I feel bad for Vishnevsky. He's Randy Lattiser and Lucic is Cam Neely.
Briabet to the front of the net is Vishnevsky, and he just tipped it wide, and Bernier is shaken. Look out now. There's Legion into it with Vishnevsky, and Bernier's in some difficulty.
You never like to see this. Obviously, Jonathan Bernier was hurt in the Memorial Cup last year playing for the Lewiston Maniacs. The Russians on a quick counter trying to get something done. And then it's a collision with the defenseman, Vishnevsky, driving by Stefan Legion. Now, there's nothing, you know, that's a hard play at the goal, Peter, and this is a contact sport. Stuff's going to happen. And I know the Canadian people are cheering for Jonathan Bernier. Nobody wants to see anybody get hurt. But that's part of what happens in hockey. This is not a dirty play by Vishnevsky. It's a bang-bang play on the goal. He's just trying to fight for his position. He and Stefan Legion both collide with Jonathan Bernier, and stuff happens in hockey.
Bernier being attended to by athletic therapist Doug Stacey. And you certainly hope he's okay. A look at Vishnevsky, who's signed an entry-level contract with the Dallas Stars.
And the reason why I brought up the Cam Neely, Randy Lattiser situation, when I was coaching in Hartford and Lattiser was playing defense for us and Cam Neely was in his prime for the Boston Bruins, the collisions those guys used to have are much like Lucic and Vishnevsky. Bernier going down, Bernier getting up, Brent Sutter okay with that, and the Canadian bench motivated to go another step further.
Bernier stopped all nine that he's faced in this period. He stopped all 23 that he faced in a game two shutout.
David Conte's here evaluating Brent Sutter. No, I'm only kidding. David Conte's the director of player personnel. He's actually here watching Alexander Vasunov, who's a second round pick in 06.
And Kirill Tulupov, who was a third round pick of New Jersey in 06.
And the new coach, Brent Sutter. See what he can do.
I think he's okay. Here is Vasunov late in the period. Working against Shen. Vasunov, backhander net comes off its mooring again. And that might be the best burst that we've seen from Vasunov in the entire event.
Luke Shen, again, so strong defensively and aware. And it's Vasunov and Shen one-on-one. Shen tries to contain his speed. He goes hard with him to the net, doesn't give him easy access. And that's what you want from a big physical defenseman like Luke Shen. Make sure the forwards know on the opposition team, every time you try to take me to the net, I am going to punish you. I'm going to do it cleanly, but I'm going to do it hard.
Ellerby has taken a penalty. It looked more like it might have been Shen with the infraction. The call is holding. Maybe away from the puck. I didn't really see anything where Ellerby was concerned. So a last-minute power play opportunity for the Russians. Voyanov for Maxim Mamin. He finds Vasunov. His shot blocked. Bashkirov out there as well. In his first game of the series, Brandon Sutter with another block shot. Hyatt clears it out. As the buzzer goes, Jonathan Bernier and Team Canada tied with the Russians after 20 minutes here in Winnipeg.
Tomorrow night, we're back in another great Western Canadian hockey town, Saskatoon, for Game 6, 8 o'clock Eastern Time on TSN. James Duffy back with you. You know, there are certain qualities it seems all great young Canadian hockey players have. They're all extremely talented. They're all extremely dedicated. And they're all cousins of Shane Doan. And they're not all quite cousins of Shane Doan. It just seems that way. Carey Price, gold medal winning goaltender in the last World Juniors, cousin of Shane Doan. And now the latest Doan clone, Keaton Ellerbe.
Hi, I'm Keaton Ellerbe, and I'm a proud member of Team Canada.
When I started off ice training, I was probably 14 years old. Now, if you don't do it, then you're going to get passed by everybody.
I think he's sort of committed himself to getting a little bit bigger this year, a little bit stronger.
My offense, I need to work on. I've been working on it. It's gotten a lot better. I need to get bigger. I need to fill up my frame. And after that, I grew a ridiculous amount, so I think I'm still growing.
I think Keaton had a growth spurt in between the years of the Bantam draft and when he's made this hockey club.
My training regime is just a lot of weight exercises and whatnot. I'm still not the biggest guy. I'm tall, but I haven't really filled out my frame yet, so I got to do a lot of weight, a lot of lifting, and I still work on cardio, obviously.
It's important to have fun. I like to play golf. I'm terrible at it, but I definitely like to come out and try my best and try and get better at it.
He skates extremely well. He's got a fluid stride. He's got a good head on for the game. He sees the ice well. He's dependable on our end, plays a solid defensive game. He can shoot the puck a million miles an hour.
You just got to go out there and just do everything to the best of your ability, no matter what it is.
Keaton Ellerbe's a tough kid, and you have to be able to play in the Boxing Day game between the Ellerbes and the Doans. His dad was a tough nut in the Western Hockey League. His uncle, tough bloodlines there.
Carey Price still comes over in the summer, and they shoot groundhogs together. I don't know if that is that politically correct. I'm not sure. But hey, it's what you do sometimes in the West.
Hey, not bad for a guy who was never drafted in the Bantam draft in the WHL.
Absolutely. Oh, good get-ups they have going. That looks like one of those Russian hats they were giving for the MVPs. 0-0, second period just ahead. Your first period lack of scoring summary brought to you by Nike. Medals last longer than pain. Join the summer shift at niketraining.ca. The shots dead even. Both teams struggling on the power play, but Bobrovsky, the Russian goaltender, is definitely the story. The man responsible for finding all of Team Canada's talent is Al Murray, the head scout. He's with our Ryan Rashad.
Well, Al, it's your job to keep a bead on the level of talent in Canada among young hockey players. It's been talked about a lot in recent years and maybe questioned. What do you see in Canadian talent right now?
Well, I've been fortunate. I've got two sons in minor hockey right now that are coming through the system, as well as getting to see hockey at all levels, junior A, junior B, triple A midget, and I don't see any problem. I got to be honest with you. I think our players out here are competing well with a team that's a very highly skilled team. And as I go back through all the levels of hockey, I really don't see any problem. I think our coaches in Canada are doing a great job developing talent.
Thanks for this, Al.
My pleasure. Thanks.
Best thing you can say about Canadian hockey right now is the problem isn't finding talent. It's whittling it down and paring down that roster, selecting the few that will play for Team Canada. You'll watch them in a second. Right now, here's Peter Labardius and Pierre Maguire.
James, thank you very kindly. Canada will start this period shorthanded for a minute and 26. That's what's remaining in the penalty to Keaton Ellerbe. The Canadian edge in goaltending prior to this contest, Mr. Maguire, has been large, but Sergei Bobrovsky making his second consecutive start, he was gigantic in the first period.
Shots don't do justice to the stats. They say the shots were 9-9 in the first period, but Canada outchanced Russia 12-4. Bobrovsky was the difference in the first period, and that's why it's 0-0.
How interesting has that been in this series? When the Russians came in with Semen Varlamov, he's already played in two World Junior Championships, yet right now he's taken a complete back seat to Bobrovsky, and rightly so. Varlamov, in his two appearances in this event, was not very good at all. He was pulled after the first period of Game 3.
Russia should have won Game 1. Varlamov was that bad. And Russia could never get their confidence level back after that.
Ryabin on the power play with Anisimov and Dodonov. Alexandrov, a shot blockered into the mesh by Bernier.
This is what you like about Jonathan Bernier. And if you're Mark Crawford and Dean Lombardi, the people running the LA Kings, you got to be real excited. You watch how his head follows the puck. Follows the puck, gets up, he's square, he doesn't guess, and he makes himself look big. A lot of guys would drop in that situation, not Jonathan Bernier. That tells me he's not far from being NHL ready.
Product of Laval, Quebec, in their minor hockey system. Vizhnevsky. Watch closely, Legion had a beat on him, but it ended up slamming into the boards, and I think he's going to take a penalty. Vizhnevsky, good lead feed for Ryabev with Alexandrov. Anisimov, his stick was lifted.
We're going to call a tripping penalty on Stefan Legion. Brent Sutter not pleased about on the Canadian bench. Stefan Legion goes and gets physical. I don't know. Okay. Again, though, Stefan Legion's trying to be physical. He's trying to compete. He's throwing his weight around. He has all series long. Now he's in the box.
So let me understand this. That was tripping on Legion.
Right.
Even though he was just tripped up.
Right.
Is that what I just saw?
Okay. Correct.
I'll leave it at that. Chidinov, a two-man Russian power play. They've had several in this series, have yet to connect with one. Voyanov, Bernier found it, stopped it, and held on.
And that's the thing you got to be careful of with Voyanov, because he can just absolutely rip it. They've got their sticks inverted on the point, and they're looking for the one-timer from 30 in red. Voyanov, you'll see him just hammer time the puck after he gets a soft little one-time opportunity here. But this is Jonathan Bernier again. No rebound, making himself look big.
Doughty blocks the shot of Chudinov. The 2-17-year-old anchoring the power play. Allsner trying to clear it. Sutter, with the help of Ellerby in Canada, is now just one man short. Maxim Chidinov. Vasunov slides it, but right to Kyle Turris. And Turris finds an opening. Giroux will pressure Bobrovsky. Voyanov slides it too far for Ryabev, and the Russians are forced to regroup. Voyanov for Anisimov, the Rangers' second rounder. On the diagonal dump it, Giroux makes no mistake.
That's the adjustment the Russians have to make. They've got to get better in terms of shooting and retrieval. You said it best, Peter, it's a diagonal shoot-in, but there's no first-man pressure. They're not all on the same page. It's more in an individual game rather than a team game. There's another shooter. Bernier just can't get out to handle it. Two guys are on the puck, but they really don't know what to do once they get there.
Anisimov trying to jam it home on the short side. Good save by Bernier. Myrov to the front of the net. Tadana. Pavel Duronin, he has a goal in this series. Backhander, Myrov had two chances. Dodonov, and Bernier stops all three of them. Gillies was interfered with. And there will be a Russian penalty.
There will be, because Jonathan Bernier again makes himself look big. And you watch how he stays with the play, Peter. That's the key to Jonathan Bernier. You know, he's a good athlete. He's not overly large at 6 feet, about 180 pounds. But you see his head's always aware. First shot, second shot, slides across. Third shot, makes it look easy. And here comes the penalty. Interference right there to Evgeny Dadanov. But it's just Jonathan Bernier's fundamentals that make him so strong.
Bernier was the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League's playoff MVP, leading Lewiston to the Memorial Cup. He went 16-1 on the run. Here's Giroux. He's free. He scores. What a goal by Claude Giroux.
Finished by Claude Giroux, but what a pass by Gagne again, protecting the puck, throwing it right on to Giroux with speed. go in, look like Pete Mihaljevic and finish it off from 1972 in Toronto. Sam Gagner keeps getting better, keeps making the players around him better. And when you have skill like Claude Giroux, you can make all kinds of things look special.
Claude Giroux, 48 goals last season with the Gatineau Olympique, has his second of this Super Series, and Canada strikes first. That was pretty. Marchand just avoids a hit. And Gagné with his series-leading 8 points. Lukov carries in against Godfrey. Good battle. Lukov. Stripped of a puck by Gagné. Sam Gagné for Giroux. With Marchand. Held in at the line by Hickey. And Jenny Bodrov trying to spin away from Hickey. He would have none of it. And Gagné settles things down. Following the game's opening goal by Claude Giroux. That line's still out there.
Too long a shift. Got to get it deep and get off.
Godfrey with his third assist of the event as well at 3:18. Hickey away from Beshkinov.
Peter, are you with me that Thomas Hickey's really improved a lot?
Better every game. Vasunov kicked away by Bernier. As Hickey steers it. Perron in pursuit of Mammon, who shielded him before then losing it. Turris with Tavares and Perron now. Chen thinking about jumping up. And Mammon steals. Outlet too far. This is Isaac. Canada on the board in period number two.
Curtis Hunt did a real nice job in Leksand, Sweden last year, I thought, with Team Canada.
He's a heck of a coach. Marchand. Good feed. Gagné hit the side of the net. Giroux scores.
Comes down a face-off. Sam Gagné, little help from his friends. Good job walking the line by Hickey. And then you see Marsha going back door. They can't finish it off. Gagne's in the crease, and there's a finish by Giroux. But a look at the heads-up play by Marchand going down low. Couldn't finish the playoff. And then the smart read and react by Claude Giroux. Second goal of the game.
Claude Giroux's third of the Super Series, and Canada opens a two-goal advantage as Beshkirov drives to the net, forcing Bernier to make a good save from close range. Good pass, Tavares. He's partially free. Tavares stuck by Bobrovsky as the net comes off its mooring again.
I heard Al Murray talking to Ryan Rashog about the skill level of the Canadian players. It's not just the one-on-one abilities of Team Canada. It's a concept of how to play as a team. Smart down low, good puck movement, insulation. Kyle Turris whips that pass over to John Tavares. He can come with speed. And look at David Perron looking for the rebound. He doesn't go by the net. He stops in front of the goaltender. That's team play. That's a skill of the Canadians that the Russians don't have right now. They can play as individuals. They can't not play as a team like Canada can.
Well, well stated. And the Russians, giving up the 2 second period goals, have called a timeout. The last Canadian goal, Giroux's second, another assist for Sam Gagné.
That face-offs have been so one-sided for Canada over Russia, Peter, this whole series. And Sergei Nemchinov was such a good player when he played in the NHL. It was 11 years, winning 2 Stanley Cups, one in New Jersey, one in New York. But we're not seeing a lot of the same Nemchinov qualities of him as a player with his team as we are seeing the Sutter qualities with his team when he was a player.
Such a difference in this series. And the fans are riled up with these 2 second period Canadian goals. Tavares dumped after a good scoring chance. Just before the puck drop. Perron can't beat three defenders. The Sunak in transition. Neither could he. Voyanok, he'll tee it up. And Bernier, he just looks like, what might it take to beat him?
There's not a lot of negative with Team Canada, but David Perron right here, that puck's got to get deep. Instead, he tries to get cute in the neutral zone, one on two. Brent Sutter will not like that. I would be very surprised if Perron got the next shift that he should. That is not something that makes Brent Sutter very happy. You can see the scowl on his face. And as he looks down the bench, he's looking right at David Perron.
The big cheer in the building was for Jonathan Toews being shown on the scoreboard. He was okay at the World Junior. Backhand try for Anisimov, robbed by Bernier.
He's going to be okay with the Chicago Blackhawks too. Talking to Don Vasey, the legendary agent from Manitoba, he thinks Toews got a chance to be the best player ever out of the province of Manitoba.
Just offside at the line, and keep in mind that Toews is eligible for this event.
Yeah, he is. You know, the performance he put on against the Americans with the shootout goals was just spectacular. I'm not sure, and you take Mario Lemieux, you take Wayne Gretzky, and I say that with all due respect to those guys, and put them in that situation at that age, I'm not sure they're going to go 3-for-3. That was just an unbelievable performance. And to be in the building and witness it, Peter, was spectacular.
And how about the two huge plays he made in the gold medal game as well? And didn't look out of place at the Senior Men's World Championship either, where he won again. All that kid has done in his life is win, dating all the way back to Panama. As Godfrey delivers some punishment on Kablukov, and they exchange unpleasantries, and there's going to be a penalty.
Godfrey's going to go for cross-checking. I think this is more like 2 minutes for being strong. There's no cross-check there. That's just 2 minutes for being strong, and that's one of the things you have when you deal with the Russians or European officials. Whenever they see a free hand come up into the chest and they see a player in the opposition on the receiving end of the hit going down, see Brent Sutter talking to Pete DeBoer? What kind of call is that? That's just good hard hockey by Josh Godfrey. He won't get in any trouble at all from his coach. That's a questionable call by the official. That was not a cross check.
2 second period goals by Claude Giroux as Canada in front. And the Russians about to experience power play number 6. Oh, for their last 37 attempts. Shin steals from Bisounov, can't get it out. Herbata. Voyanov fans on it. Mamin up front with Bisounov and Bashkirov. One of the top rookies Bashkirov was last year with Patrick Roy's Quebec Ramparts, but he's elected to stay at home this year. He's in front, but Shin broke up the pass from Bisounov. Mamin working against Keaton Ellerby. Bashkirov, a little room. Herbatov blocked by Ellerby and backhanded out. Bisounov. Good pass. Bashkirov in behind the defender. Quick wrist shot stopped by Bernier. Giroux out there in a penalty killing role. Brandon Sutter. Tips it for Pyatt. Still loose. Bisounov's got a great chance. He scores. Alexander Bisounov on the power play, and the Russians back in it.
This is something that's been very uncharacteristic of Canada throughout the series, their inability to get the puck up and out of the zone. We saw it in the first period, and we're seeing it again here in the second period. Canada had numerous chances to get the puck out. They're just not strong enough on the puck. Maybe the jet lag, maybe the fatigue. There's two different opportunities to get it out. There's a third opportunity, and then the finish, and a good finish by Alexander Bisounov. But Canada just not strong enough on the puck in that situation. Give the Russians a lot of credit. They didn't quit on the play. And at some point, if you're the goaltender, you're going to get hung out to dry if you guys don't get the puck up and out of the zone.
Bisounov's first of the Super Series. And the Russians finally snap that lengthy power play drought.
unassisted at 9:56.
Right back on the cycle. Tavares, Turris, Perron. And that's another thing Pierre Canada's done so well. The minute the Russians get any breathing room, Canada seems to take it away again. Dodonov deflects into the corner. Anisimov let it go quickly. Perron, 4 points in this series. Puts on the brakes for Turris from New Westminster, British Columbia. Tavares. Perron working against Daronin. Pops over the stick of Perron, who will go and get it. Through Doughty. Lost it. Dodonov at 2-on-1 with Ryabev. Dodonov, wrist shot, stop Bernier, and hangs on. The Russians are within a goal.
The 2008 Men's World Hockey Championship coming to Canada for the first time ever next May, the 1st to the 18th. It's the 100th anniversary of the event. Halifax and Quebec holding the games. HockeyCanada.ca for more.
Alexander Vasunov, his first of this Super Series, unassisted at 8:56, have the Russians on the board, and then, Pierre, they had a 2-on-1 opportunity shortly thereafter.
Yeah, and again, I think the fatigue factor's kicking in for the Canadians, and maybe a little bit of the nervous energy's out of their legs. They'll reel it back in. The leadership's too strong.
Soladukin with Kablukov and Myrov. Penalty for tripping, and it's going to Canada as Myrov was spilled. Once again, in case you just tuned in, tonight the Russian referees working. Tomorrow it will be a Canadian duo.
This will be interesting to see on this call. Corey Emerton in the box.
Emerton from St. Thomas, Ontario.
Plays for the Kingston Frontenacs, drafted by the Detroit Red Wings.
Second round selection in 06. The Russians look for an equalizer. Chudinov, fans on it, blocked by Brandon Sutter. Chudinov's stick is broken. Kalupov carries on. Luke Shen to the puck, chipped out by Brandon Sutter for Legion, but he overskated it. And Ellerby sends it the distance. The Russians' goal did come on the power play from Vasunov. Kalupov overskates it. Bashkirov with Mammon and Dodonov. Bashkirov. Kurbatov. Dodonov to the front of the net. Nifty pass. A weak shot. Here comes Turris with Giroux. Turris, wrist shot. Good save by Bobrovsky, and then Turris failed to backhand it on target. Kyle Turris looking for his fourth of this event. And now he steals it. Pyatt, a blast, he scores! Logan Pyatt, short-handed.
The more you watch Kyle Turris, the more you like what the Phoenix Coyotes did with the third pick overall in the 07 entry draft. Number 19 in red never quits. Goes in there, they're shorthanded. Instead of forcing a turnover, he goes to the open man, Logan Pyatt, with time and space, and it's hammer time. But this is what you love, the never quit. Voinov separated from the puck. He could have forced in the slot. No, takes his time, gets it out to the late man, and then boom, to the back of the net by Logan Pyatt. Kyle Turris bringing it.
Legion looking for more shorthanded. Pyatt was a 14-goal scorer with the Regina Pats last season. Kyle Turris! Contreras obviously drawing an assist. And Pierre again. Canada has an answer.
The answer is fundamentally sound guys in the lane. Watch Canada in the lane coming up for the shot block. No, forces the Russian to shoot wide. And now you get the quick counterattack. Kyle Turris going hard with Giroux. Creates a two-on-one. That was all because of body position by the Canes. It eventually leads to the Logan Piatt goal. But it's the end-zone coverage, the responsibility of the players doing what they're supposed to do, which leads to that opportunity.
Last time Logan Piatt scored a big shorthanded goal for Canada, the 05 gold medal game of the Junior World Cup in the Czech Republic, he scored the shorthanded winner in a 5-3 victory in that game over the Czechs. Emerton, good speed to the front of the net by Emerton.
Russian's played this whole series tonight.
Keeps getting stronger. Missed a large part of last season with a broken ankle that he suffered in December. And just starting to get back to full health is Corey Emerton. Marchand greeted by Chidina. No goals in the first, four in the second as Marchand backhands it. That should be a penalty.
No.
3-1, Canada in front.
Now Brent Sutter would have another guy at his disposal if this guy hadn't turned pro. Jonathan Toews, a native of Winnipeg, Manitoba, getting ready for his first NHL training camp with the Chicago Blackhawks. Got the pretty good pythons going, so clearly he's been working out this summer.
I hear he is in just fabulous shape.
I think Jonathan Toews is going to be like Brian Trotsky. Some people think he's going to be like Joe Sakic. I think he brings a little bit more of the physical part of the game than Joe does. I don't know if he has the high-end offensive skill that Joe has, but I know he's got the grit, determination, and leadership qualities of Brian Trotsky, who I had the privilege of working with for 2 years in Pittsburgh. That's pretty high praise. Trotsky was a great player.
Is it ever Turris trying to go upstairs, and Bobrovsky with a terrific glove save.
We keep talking about it, Peter, but Kyle Turris, have you ever seen a young player elevate the puck as quickly as he can?
No, the way he gets
it up.
You know who it kind of reminds me a little of? And that's unfair, too. Another guy who used to get it up in traffic so quickly. You know, you used to coach him. Mario Lemieux.
Not bad. You don't coach players like Mario. You maintain them. They're like a live, great car. You put the oil in, you put the gas in, you make sure there's air in the tires. They take care of everything else. Sergei Nemchinov used to be a checker against Mario Lemieux when he played for the New York Rangers and Mario played for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
How about Mario going upstairs in double overtime in game two of the Canada Cup?
Yes.
Maybe the greatest game of all time. Bashkirov. One-on-one versus Hellerby. Stays with it, though. Bashkirov driving the net. Ran into the goaltender, and there'll be a penalty on Bashkirov. Turris. One at Hellerby, who jumped up on the rush.
Peter, do you remember when we talked about David Perron and his turnover in the neutral zone? You watch who comes back to bail Keaton Ellerby out. Keaton does a real good job there on Bashkirov. 16 in red. David Perron coming back to help out. Brent Sutter, I guarantee you, got in his ear and whispered a little sweet nothing. You don't start playing the way I want you to play, you're not going to play. That's excellent effort by David Perron.
Mishunov gets the call for charging. And Canada back to the power play. Claude Giroux has a power play goal in this period. He has two in the game to lead the way. Gagne has two more assists. Giroux and Lucic. This is a bit of a different combination. Gagne, wrist shot. Stopped.
I think Brent Sutter's looking for more of a physical edge. That's why he's got Lucic in the slot. He's got the skill guys with Gagne, obviously, and Giroux. But I think he's looking for the big hammer in front of Lucic.
The Vancouver Giants captain, second round pick to the Boston Bruins. We know he'll be excited about playing at home on Sunday. Will Milan Lucic.
See that little play by Lucic right there on Grecian. That's why they had him out there, just for retrieval purposes.
Godfrey, Hickey. He'll tee it up or wanted to. That big shot of Godfrey. Blocked by Kabluka. And the Soladukin will move it out of the zone. Thomas Hickey.
Well, Sam Gagner, first round pick of the Edmonton Oilers. Peter, I gotta believe he's gonna have every opportunity to make that team this year. They're looking for offense, obviously. They're a team that a lot of people think won't produce to the level that will be necessary to get them in the playoffs in the Western Conference. But Kevin Lowe and Kevin Prendergast, as director of player personnel, got to be so excited about the drafting of Sam Gagner.
Boy, he performed well in this series.
High stick coming up. Yuri Alexandrov, a second-round pick of the Bruins, gets a high stick up on David Perron, and he'll go. Canada's going to have a 5-on-3. It's just in a foot race situation. Perron so quick to the point of attack. Alexandrov can't contain him, so he gets the stick up into the bush.
Ouch.
But again, it's a speed factor. You know, everybody asks me, what's the biggest difference between Canada now and maybe 15 years ago? There are no slow pokes on Canada. Every guy can wheel. Every single guy can wheel. Canada's no longer an underdog whenever it comes to skating against a world championship team like the Russians.
No skill issue. Tavares, 5-on-3. Tavares ripped it. Greason. Tavares will move over with Doughty. Drew Doughty's got some time and space. Tavares, top of the circle, shot it wide, and somehow it finds its way in.
I'm convinced that Tavares is so smart, he shot it high off the glass on purpose. You watch what happens when he takes his puck from his foot and puts it to his stick. He sees that there's an opening, but he can't get it to the net, so he gets it wide off the glass. You'll see that Doughty gets it down low. The puck's going to come out to Tavares from his skate to his stick. He shoots that high on purpose because he knows he can't get it there. He's just looking for a rebound opportunity. That thing's going high on purpose and wide. And then the scramble down low and Canada capitalized on it. That's just the awareness of a great young player. That's an outstanding job.
David Perron will likely get credit. It did tear him off of his leg and in. And another power play goal for the Canadiens. Perron with his second of the Super Series, and the difference is 3. Giroux, Lucic, for Giroux on the return, broken up. Godfrey collides with Kabukov, and the puck ends up in row 5.
Josh Godfrey right there with the big shot. Really improved under Craig Hartsburg after being traded from Kingston to Sault Ste. Marie. 24 goals last year with Sault Ste. Marie. David Perron getting another goal. St. Louis lose first round pick. He's got all kinds of offensive abilities. Now he's got to buy into the team concept. He played for the Lewiston Maniacs last year in Clemence Jodelin. By the way, Clemence Jodelin, the new coach and director of hockey operations with the Rimouski Oceanic.
And they have a lot of very talented young players.
He's a talented coach.
Is he ever. Hickey. Canada still on the power play after the power play marker from Perron, Tavares, and Drew Doughty. Doughty's first point of the event. Hickey, good diagonal pass. Gagne and Bobrovsky got a piece. Godfrey held it in on target, rebound, scores! Gagne finds the net.
Having a power play quarterback that can run things from the back end is huge. Josh Godfrey, we're talking about his development, number 2 in red. He gets it. Instead of standing still, he walks the line. That opens up the seam. And then Sam Gagne, so smart, elusive. That little movement to the inside opens everything up. Quick shot on goal, and then the juicy rebound for Sam Gagne. He elevates the puck. Makes it 5-1 Canada.
Sam Gagne's second consecutive 3-point game in this series. has a goal and two assists. Giroux will have a three-point outing as well. And Canada's blown it wide open here in period number two. The lead is four.
Well, let's face it, the question now is, can they go 8-0? We'll find out. Saskatoon, Red Deer, and Vancouver, the last three games in the series. You can still get tickets, hockeycanada.ca, ticketmaster.ca, and local Ticketmaster outlets. Once again, Peter and Pierre.
Five, one, Canada in front. They've exploded 4-5 in this period. And the last goal, Gagne's fourth attempt from Godfrey and Giroux on the power play at 16-21. Bashkirov with Mishunov, his high shot over top of the key.
Well, at least Bashkirov wants to compete. That's the good news for the Russians.
Legion.
No!
Takes a hard hit from Voynov. Voynov sweeps it and just out of the zone as Hickey fails to hold it in. Mishunov, he has the Russian goal tonight. Nice move. Mishunov to the front. He's held up, and there will be a penalty to Josh Godfrey, or Mikhail Logan Pyatt.
One-on-one situation. Mishunov with speed going around Logan Pyatt. And I think Pyatt does get a little bit of a holdout on him. The Russian referee makes the call. And you'll see Mishunov fake the shot a little bit. Logan Pyatt loses a little bit of body position. Then the free hand comes up. You might have got away with that 4 years ago. You're not getting away with the free hand now. That's called in the NHL the same way as it's called in international hockey.
Eighth power play attempt for the Russians. Their lone goal came on the manpower advantage. They desperately need one here. Pass for Kablukov, broken up by Doughty. Soladukin has it again with Kablukov to the front of the net. Wrist shot by Myrov, missed. Soladukin. Alexei Grishin, nice play. Heronin tipped. Bernier stopped Soladukin.
This is a little bit lackadaisical in terms of Canada's in-zone coverage, and it's something that I'm sure Brent Sutter's not going to be happy with. They've got internal goals, and one of them is winning all eight games. Guys are running around, Alsner and Doughty on defense, just a little bit loose. Jonathan Bernier coming up with a nice save off the deflection. But I think Canada wants to be a little tighter with their slot area coverage.
Vizhnevsky. Alexandrov turned aside by Bernier. He stopped 21 of the 22 that he's faced. Dadana. Watched closely by Ellerby. Dadana. Anisimov parked in front. Where's he been in this event? Ryabov, Vizhnevsky, nothing but perimeter play. Ryabov takes a look. Dadonov, Gillies intercepts it, turns. Nice little backhand pass off the boards for Shen. Those don't show up on the stat sheet, but they help. Mishunov. Last ditch effort on this power play as we're into the closing moment of period two. Canada with five goals in it. Voynov, wrist shot, Bernier the save, big rebound. Penalty to Pyatt is over. Mishunov knocked down by Godfrey. And Giroux, the outlet for Pyatt. Turris has some room. Turris flipped it wide. Giroux with 3 points in the game. still with it for Curris. Mammon settles things down to that top. Baskirov, and out it goes. Period over. Canada in full command in Winnipeg.
Here's your second period scoring summary brought to you by Chevrolet. Let's go. Visit letsgochevrolet.ca. What a difference 8 months or so makes for Sam Gagne. Remember at the World Juniors, didn't play a lot, did not get a single point. 3 points in the second period. He now has 10. First guy in double digits in the tournament leading the way. Drew Doughty also with his first point, finally, of the series for Canada. Here are Pierre and Peter with the call of the third.
Thank you, James. A look at Jonathan Bernier and Super Series 2007. 20 minutes away from being 5-0 Team Canada and series over.
Well, I think what people have to start focusing in on right now, Peter, the greatness of the Canadian team, the greatness of the coach, Brent Sutter, and the passion that these players have to represent Canada. So if you live in Saskatoon, these guys are playing for you. If you live in Red Deer, these guys are playing for you. And if you live in Vancouver, these guys care about you. They care about this whole country. That's the amazing part of the battle these young men have put forth ever since day one of training camp in Moscow when you and I were there. Now, the one interesting thing that I'd like to also focus on, 2010, the Olympic Games are in Vancouver. Brent Sutter, right now, to me, is the leading candidate to be the head coach of that team. Any other thought about any other coach would be flawed. And everybody's saying, well, what about how he's going to do with the New Jersey Devils and dealing with NHL players? He'll be absolutely fine. He played in the NHL for 18 years. He played for Al Arbor. He played for Mike Keenan. He played for his brother. He played for Craig Hartsburg. He was an unbelievable leader. He knows what it takes to be an NHL player. He should be the coach of the 2010 Olympic team.
He is 20 minutes away from going 17-0 in World Junior type competition. That is beyond impressive. When you consider at the elite level and at World Juniors the difference between winning and losing, to have that kind of a record, spectacular. Tavares trying to jam it home. Bobrovsky the save. Sergei Bobrovsky's in need of one thing right now.
Yeah, uncle.
A lawyer.
He's going to call uncle anytime. Now get me out of here.
Good lead pass, Ellerby, for Perron, who has one of the five Canadian goals. Don't expect Canada to take its foot off the pedal either. Here's a partial 3-on-2.
For a lot of these players, this is a dress rehearsal for the World Junior. There are a lot of good Canadian players who aren't here that might win chances to be on the World Junior team that's going to the Czech Republic.
And remember, Canada with a 25-man roster in this event, only 22 will go to the Czech Republic.
I think of Steve Stamkos or the Sarnia Sting. I think of Alex Pietrangelo. And there are other guys out there as well.
Tyler Ennis of the Medicine Hat Tigers.
Logan Couture.
There's Lotz. Grecian. Blocked again. I wonder how many times I've said blocked.
I don't know, but we can show it a lot.
The commitment to excellence by this Canadian crew in this event has been fabulous.
Because guys sacrifice. A lot of these guys, like Stefan Legion, for instance, that just had two block shots. He had 43 goals this year playing for Mississauga. But he's not here to be a goal scorer. He's here to be a role player. You get in the avenue, you do what Brent Sutter wants, you block shots, not once, but twice. And that's the beauty of this whole thing that Brent Sutter's created. Guys understand their roles, they buy in. Doesn't matter if you're a 43 goal scorer like Stefan Legion, or a 13 goal scorer like Colton Gillies, you get it.
Or a 48 goal getter like Claude Giroux has two Canadian goals in this game.
And how about that? They get the puck in, shoot it in so they can change on the fly. It's 5-1. That's Mike Keenan and Brent Sutter. Mike Keenan coach the same way. Never let off the accelerator. Keep your matchup going all the time. Pat Burns, the same way.
Logan Pyatt scored a key shorthanded goal, his first of this Super Series, that gave Canada a 3-1 lead.
Canada outscored Russia so far in this series 10-2 in the second period. That says something to me, Peter, about the leadership of the Canadian team. After the first 20 minutes, they go back in the room. Guys don't lose their train of thought or their focus. They come out ready to jam in the second period. The Russian players, not so much.
There were no goals after 20 minutes of play here tonight in Winnipeg. Voynov. Rink wide, Vasunov, who's probably been the best Russian forward in the game. Deflected off Ellerby's stick out of play.
That's going to be a long trip to Saskatoon for these Russian players, and it's not so much because they're bad players, it's because their confidence value has been shattered. And for them to get a competitive edge going, it's going to be very, very difficult for their game tomorrow night in Saskatoon.
That is where we'll be. We'll have all the action right here on TSN, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. Luke Shen's excited. He's from Saskatoon. I'm excited. I'm from Saskatoon.
Hey, now, where's Milestone, Saskatchewan? Because that's where Logan Pyatt's from.
Milestone, Saskatchewan is about 40 minutes outside of Regina, south of Regina.
So not far from Wilcox, Saskatchewan.
Not at all.
I spent a lot of time watching players earlier in my career.
About 10 minutes away, my friend.
Saw some pretty good ones there. Rod Brindamore. Guy by the name of Kent Manderville.
Curtis Joseph was there.
James Patrick, Wendell Clark, Russ Cortinel.
What a factory.
No. Tremendous. Been another tremendous outing by these young Canadians. Maria Bev with Anisimov and Dodona. As Legion chips it out and makes the play. Stefan Legion was voted the most improved player in the Ontario Hockey League by the coaches.
Watch this call. This is a phantom call for roughing against Stefan Legion. The Malachi crunch is coming in right in the neutral zone, 21 and 12. That's the roughing call. Legion's just actually letting up.
Legion takes a seat, 3:06 into the period, and the Russians back to the power play. It will be for the ninth time. Their lone goal was a Vasunov power play marker. Pyatt has an assist to go with that shorthanded goal. Scoops it out. Yeah, fair to say that the CHL developed some pretty good players.
Unbelievable.
Colton Gillies is one of them, as is Brandon Sutter.
Minnesota Wild have sent two scouts here tonight to watch Colton Gillies. Blair McAsee, who used to run the scouting for Hockey Canada, and Tommy Thompson, whose hometown is actually Winnipeg, but he now lives down in Minnesota.
Kablukov, he's a Vancouver pick. Konstantin Kulikov and Myra. Alsner. All Carl Alsner does is make good play after good play after good play.
You know what? He's going to have a legitimate chance to make the Washington Capitals. I really believe that, Peter.
You will get no argument from this guy.
He has played so well in this series. He and Drew Doughty, what a tandem.
Does everything so smartly. Here's Vasunov trying to jam it by Bernier, who stopped him twice. Kerbeta down low, Ryabev with Mammon. Alexander Ryabev. Bashkirov, that's blocked. Another chance in Jonathan Bernier with one of his best efforts of this game.
Bashkirov has been one of the better Russians. And he deserves a lot of credit for not quitting, because he wasn't even on this team when the series started. Alexander Vasunov's been the other good Russian. Good movement. There's a big shot by Voynov, and Bashkirov goes for the loose puck, but there's Jonathan Bernier just reaching out. Again, he's just so strong, he's so square, and he's so athletic. The depth of Canadian goaltending. Outside the Finns, no country in the world is producing goaltenders like Canada.
Well, this Canadian team has a great trio in Bernier, Mason, and Leland Irving, and we are likely to see Irving tomorrow in Saskatoon. What a great story Leland Irving is. At the age of 8, he was diagnosed with a rare form of cancer and beat it. And it's gone on to be a first-round pick of the Calgary Flames. And already has a World Junior gold medal to his credit, be it in a backup role to Carey Price. Claude Giroux, good pass, just offside. Legion out of the penalty box. They're enjoying themselves in the Manitoba capital.
Lots more action coming in November to TSN. The World Junior A Challenges in Trail BC. That's November 4th to the 11th. And the National Women's Under 18 Championship in Kitchener, Ontario, the next week, 7th to the 11th.
A look at the Team Canada Retro 1972 jerseys. Those are going on auction on both HockeyCanada.ca and eBay.ca. The bid period will close for those jerseys on September the 12th. The helmets, the white helmets the Canadians are wearing, those will be up for auction as well. ...5-1 Canada leading. A look at Zach Boychuk from Airdrie, Alberta.
How about his athletic ability? Zach Boychuk. Peter and I were watching Team Canada stretch out, and they were playing a soccer game, and the ball went over the boards. Zach Boychuk, in one leap, went over the boards without touching them. And I thought about hockey boards.
His sister is an elite level gymnast as well in our country. Her name is Carissa, a twin sister of Zach Boychuk, in fact.
Zach is a real good young man. Had a great visit with him at the Canadian Embassy, and his passion for the game is so huge.
And he's not alone in this group.
No, this group's very good about passion for the game.
That's a tough area for you. You struggle a little in the area of passion, I've noticed. Meyer off turning with it.
I'm lucky to have this opportunity. I just love being in the rink every day, as you know.
Yes. I'm right there with you.
Yes.
It has been an honor and a privilege to be around these Canadian young men and the staff, and just to be involved.
Going to Russia and do what we did, be the first people to have a chance to call games from outside of Moscow, was fantastic.
Something I will never forget. Zach Hamill. Down low for Boychuk. Back to Hamill. Stopped by Bobrovsky. Bashkirov in full flight. Good one-on-one play that time from Thomas Hickey. Here comes Perron. Boychuk, he can really drill it. Scores! Zach Boychuk, second of this series. It's 6-1.
Peter, here's the level of how good this team is. They don't quit. It's a simple one-on-one play. We've talked about the evolving play of Thomas Hickey. Here's an example of how good Hickey is. One-on-one situation. Read, react, step up, take Bashkirov off the puck. Support by Logan Pyatt. Now goes streaking through the neutral zone. Big time shot coming on goal. Now that should be stopped. But Zach Boychuk's the beneficiary of great defense, good passing, and excellent finishing by Canada. It all started by an awesome one-on-one play by Thomas Hickey.
Every member of the Canadian bench standing while that opportunity was upcoming. Boychuk second. He scored a goal in Omsk in game 3. And hooking is about to be the call.
John Tavares is going to get this. I think if I were the Russian referee right now, I'd stop calling penalties against Canada, because every time they do, as soon as Canada comes out of the box, they score. So they're making them mad.
Pyatt, another point.
John Tavares right in this situation. That is fraudulent. Completely and utterly fraudulent.
The last Canadian goal, Boychuk from Perron and Pyatt. At 6:53. Artem Anisimov. Nice move and a big shot, but blasted it wide of the target. Dadonov. Ryabev, watched closely by Alsner. Another good play by Alsner. So what's new? As he gloves it out of the zone. Maxim Chidinov. Legion spills Ryabev. Alsner blocks the Anisimov try. Ryabev, that hits Shannon front. Chidinov, good one-timer. Backhand off the post. Did that sneak in?
There's no instant replay here. And the goal light never went on. The puck has to go all the way across the line. But because there's no instant replay, this play will stand as is right now. Canada leads 6-1. Off the post. It's about to cross the line. The stick of Alsner comes in to keep it from crossing the line. Again, Carl Alsner coming up large. That puck never clearly went over the line, even with replay. So it stays 6-1.
And the Russian referee was in great position to make the call. Canada shorthanded. Canadian penalty killing about as good as I've ever seen at this level. Fans are wound up into the wave. Well, if you're a Canadian hockey fan, I mean, there's nothing to like in this series. How about everything? Vasunov. The lone Russian goal-getter. Mammon through neutral ice. Maxim Mammon. At it versus Keaton Ellerby, and he's gotten stronger as this event has gone on. Out of the box, Tavares on a breakaway. Tavares off the goal post, deflected in front by Emerton, and Bobrovsky stops it. Canada inches away from adding to a big lead.
Canada's skill level's high, their passing level's extremely high. John Tavares comes out of the box. Kyle Turris identifies, snaps a pass up and out of the zone. John Tavares streaking to the net. Here's a little of that skill level, and just off the post to the right of Sergei Bobrovsky. Tavares is comfortable with the puck though, Peter, on his stick. He just likes it there. I mean, when you think about 72 goals, 134 points with Oshawa, that's pretty special.
Won't turn 17 years old until the 20th of this month. And John Tavares has back-to-back seasons of 45 and 72 goals with the Oshawa Generals. Boychuk shaking on the play. He's scored here in the third. Collides with Grishin. Myrov was upended. There'll be one penalty. Will there be two? I think there will be.
I think there might be more than that. We got a lot of stuff going on away from the plate. There's one. It's two.
Canada's going to be two men short. Doughty and Boychuk in the penalty box. And you know what Lucic is asking about? What happened to Boychuk behind the play?
There's Doughty with his hole. That's the second penalty. The first one was Boychuk in the neutral zone.
After he took a whack. Alexandrov. Chidinov. Bernier kicked it away. Alsner working against Adana. Power play number 11 and 12 for the Russians. Chidinov, Bernier always seems to be in great position. That's what I love about his game. Chidinov, a little room, as you should. Blast it wide. Ryabev blocked. Alexandrov tipped by Anisimov off the side of the net. This is the best looking 5-on-3 the Russians have had, and they've had a number. How about the people of Winnipeg? Right into it. Good on you. Anisimov blocked by Olsen. Tadinov. Stop Bernier. He stopped the rebound too off Ryabin. Shen trying to free it for Brandon Sutter. Does and cleared.
It never gets old with Canada. Shot blocking, courage, and a whole lot of passion. It's the same message, but it's not ugly.
And a whole lot of skill. Bernier will play it. He's spilt. There'll be a penalty.
Carl Alsner with the big shot block. Jonathan Bernier kind of getting a chuckle at the Russian forward who skated through the crease. Maxime Mammon, who's tried to be physical all series long, but especially here in game number 5. Bernier goes out to play the puck, and Mammon just runs right into him, puts him down. Bernier never saw him. Carl Alsner, we talk about him getting in the lane. That's Artem Anisimov in the lane, cracking one on net, and Alsner blocks it.
LRB shoots it down the ice. Russians were 4-on-3 for the next 10 seconds, and then Canada will go back to the power play. And they have 3 power play goals in the game. Lesunov for Voinov. Canada now on the power play as Boychuk and Doughty out of the penalty box. Chipped on target by Bashkirov. And you're right, Pierre. I really admire the way the second-round pick of the Ottawa Senators has played in his series debut.
Right now, I'd say he's been the best Russian player. Voinov's been the second best.
You wonder why Bashkirov wasn't even invited to their original camp. He wasn't even on the original 50-man list.
Probably because he played major junior hockey. They got some bizarre ideology going on with this group. They really do.
Well, guess what? They might want to fix it. Because what they've got going is not working. Hamill. Although, to their credit, they have played for gold 5 of the last 6 years of the World Junior. Can't take that away.
Well,
Hamill in front. Good play by Kablukov to collapse on Boychuk.
But there's no Malkin, there's no Ovechkin, and those guys were premier players on those teams.
Yeah, and Mr. Sutter eliminated them, too, when it mattered most. Godfrey with a huge blast.
Nice play by Bobrovsky, the Russian goalie, to come out and challenge.
Hamill feeds it down low. Marchand, a beauty. Zach Hamill, power play, 7-1.
And they're just not going to take any prisoners. They're just going to put the pedal to the metal. It's going to be worse tomorrow in Saskatoon. Canada's going to steamroll them, not only with skill, but with physical presence, but the skill level down low. Puck movement galore. Russians very passive. Zach Hamill walking the line, goes down low, gives it to Brad Marchand. Then Marchand with a nifty little feed out front to the right-handed shooting Hamill, who puts it by poor Sergei Bobrovsky, who's getting no help from his defense. 7-1 Canada. Zach Hamill, a first-round pick of the Boston Bruins in the 07 entry draft.
8th overall has his first of the Super Series and another Canadian power play marker. They have now scored 4 power play goals in 2 games. Game 3 and now game 5. Here, how things have changed since 72. When the Russians made so much hay way back then on the power play and have in so many international competitions following. But in this event, the Canadian special teams have been superior by plenty. Lucic wants more. Milan Lucic, Gagne, and Legion. on the cycle. Mammon does well. Hamill from Marchand and Hickey. Kasunov. And you just hope it doesn't get really nasty in the dying moments. Chipped wide by Bashkirov. Moyanov moves in. Erased by Shen. Gagne fans on the flip. Shen avoids the checker. Maxime Mammon with Kulikov and Bashkirov. And Gagne with 3 points in the game sends it ahead. His second consecutive three-point outing in this series leads everyone with 10 points. Giroux and Payet also have 3 points in the game. Kurris leaning on Voyanov, who got away. Now turns it over. Kurris has it again. Kyle Kurris, backhander. How about that for skill, Canada?
Great job by Canada on the forecheck. Kyle Turris, good pressure on the back check. And then he goes and gets the puck in deep. John Tavares keeps the whole thing alive, gets it to Turris. Talk about elevation, backhand roof. Kyle Turris's thing. And the more you watch him, the more he does remind you of Steve Yzerman. It's just, it's uncanny, but that's how good this kid is.
Pierre, I'm going to ask you this. How many guys in the world can score that goal?
Very few. Very few.
That was special. Kurris with his fourth of the Super Series. Penalty to Canada.
See, that's what just kills you. You can't call that.
We'll discuss further. We promise.
Well, the 72 retro sweaters have worked well, and Hockey Canada will be auctioning them off, the official game-worn sweaters, as well as the helmets, hockeycanada.ca or ebay.ca for more info on how you can place your bid right now. All the proceeds go to Hockey Canada Development Programs and the CHL Education Fund.
Milan Lucic, part of the Canadian Hockey League, and education, Pierre, has become so, so important in that league with her scholarship programs, and they have made some unbelievable strides. David Branch, Ron Robinson, and Jill Corto in that avenue. Education, very important in the development. These are not only good young players, they're good young people. And I don't think we should ever lose sight of that. And when you're around them as much as we've been in the last 2 weeks and watch them handle themselves with class, don't forget about that either. That's important stuff. It's about people building as much as it is about a hockey player building. What a night for Canada. There could be more. Legion, backhander. Is there going to be a penalty shot? Oh, and you know the people here wanted one.
Now Maxime Chudinov goes to the box for the hook. Canada's so strong in the puck, they can't keep it in. Yuri Alexandrov can't keep the puck in. And here's Maxime Chudinov hooking on to Stefan Legion.
Legion scored an OHL-high 9 shorthanded goals last season. Gillies with Emerton. 4-on-4 hockey. Gillies will play in front of his hometown Saskatoon fans. He's a member of the Blades tomorrow night when this series continues. If you're having any second thoughts, you might want to take advantage of seeing some of Canada's up-and-coming stars. There are many on display with this group. How about the goal by Kyle Kurtz? I won't forget that one for a while.
No.
Canada 2:33 away from officially putting this Super Series to bed in terms of which team would win the series. With an exclamation point. If the papers in Russia said shame on you after game two, what might the headlines read in their country tomorrow? Marchand. What a move! Marchand, he's tripped down. Play continues. Shen's blast blocked. Less than 2 minutes to go. And an 8-1 Canadian romp. Canada exploded for 5 second period goals. This game had no goals through the first 20 minutes. Hamill has a goal in the period. For Boychuk, so does he. Couldn't direct it on net. Out there with Marchand.
This is a case of a group of men, Canada, versus a group of individuals, Russia. Canadian men have played together, the Russians haven't.
Bernier, good stock from close range after Abbott.
And that's the way it's been the whole series, Peter.
Look at the Canadian bench, still up. Fans loving every second. Stick by Pyatt, who's had a dynamite encounter. Gillies trying to break through. Kulikov with Kablukov just onside, and Bernier.
The fans are going crazy, but that's an example of the Russian individualism versus the team concept of Canada. You got to head man the puck in that situation. The potential for odd man rush is huge. But instead, Kulikov just decides to put the puck on goal with a hapless wrist shot, and the Canadian fans are saluting the greatness of their team.
Standing ovation.
Absolutely overjoyed. This is a testament to the grassroots and the greatness of the Canadian hockey program that Peter just alluded to. This thing's not going away. The Russians have a lot of soul searching to do. Their coach Sergei Nemchinov, no matchup for Brent Sutter. Their team, no match for Team Canada. This thing will get uglier as the series goes along.
8-1 with authority in Winnipeg.
The 2007 Canada-Russia Super Series is brought to you by Nike. Medals last longer than pain. Join the summer shift at niketraining.ca. And by Chevrolet. Let's go. Visit letsgochevrolet.ca.
All right, so next up, Wednesday, 8 o'clock Eastern. The series is already over. The Russians can only win 3. They'll be lucky if they win a period in the last 3 games. You can watch that one from Saskatoon on TSN. Tonight, it was an absolute pounding in the peg. Claude Giroux, one of the many heroes, and in that old sweater, does that remind you a little bit of this? Frank Mahovlich back in 72 with similar skill and deeks. The only drama left in this series is, can Canada finish it off and go 8-0? The players want to go 8-0 so that Brent Sutter goes 20-0 as a coach for Team Canada. We'll see you on TSN, Canada's sports leader.